attaching files to a chat or post message. So this is very important in terms of how you go about creating a message that's going to be either a chat message or a Teams channel post, and you want to attach a file or attach a link to a file. This is really when you fully understand how this starts to integrate the SharePoint application, the OneDrive application, so that you can have both your files and your conversations all in one place. It's where you really start to get the true collaboration value that Office 365 and Teams more specifically provides for you. So let's go ahead and take a look at this. So we'll start by attaching files to a chat message, because it's more limited in the chat. So we'll start there, and then I'll show you how to use the more advanced capabilities when adding files to a team channel post. Okay, so I started this message here to Marcia. I'm going to share a file with you, and you see in our little menu bar at the bottom of the message box, we have the paperclip. And so in the chat application, I can share a file from one or two locations. If I have a file stored locally on my computer or maybe my local file server, I can upload that file in, bring it into this message. Well, when you upload the file, where does it go? It actually gets stored in your OneDrive application. And we have courses on OneDrive and SharePoint, so we're not going to go too deep into them here. But just for now, understand that when you every user in Office 365 has a OneDrive account as part of their Office 365 subscription. And whatever files you put in OneDrive, only you will have access to those files unless you explicitly choose to share access with others. So when I go to upload a file from my computer, what it will actually do is it's uploading that file into my OneDrive. And from that point, in this message here, the recipient of the message is actually going to be able to click on the file. It's actually taking them, the link is taking them to where the file is stored in my OneDrive, because at that point I have given them access by the nature of including the file in my message. Okay, hopefully that all makes sense. Let's go ahead and do this. I'm going to go ahead and upload from my computer. And so I just have on my desktop, I have this report from McKinsey on artificial intelligence and executives. So I'm just going to, that's the file I want to upload from my local device, local storage. And so you see that it's in the process of doing that. So what it's doing right now is it's putting the file again in my OneDrive. So at this point, I'm just going to go ahead and send this. There's not much else to it. Let's see. I'll hit the send button here. And so now Marcia will receive the chat message, and she, as well as I, can go in and click on this file. So it becomes a shortcut. And so when I click on it, it's a PDF in this case. So within Teams, I'm able to preview the PDF here in the Teams application. And as a PDF, I've got some options up here. And I can actually download it. So in this case, Marcia could download it. If she wanted a copy for herself, because I haven't put any restrictions on it, she can download a copy of this file to her local storage. We can also have a conversation about this or see the conversation. So when I click Show Conversation here, notice what happens. It's actually opening up the window for me to see the conversation that we currently have going on. And I might say, I think you will find this interesting. All right, so the point of it is, now we have in this conversation, we actually have the document directly accessible. So if I go ahead and close it, you'll see here, of course, we have the thread of our conversation continuing on. But now, anytime Marcia or anybody else who might have been a party to this chat conversation can click on that and open that McKinsey report from my OneDrive. All right, so now we're going to do a second example. I'll just say, here's another file. And this time I'm going to click on the paperclip, and I'm going to choose to access the file that's already in my OneDrive. So when I click on OneDrive, and I'm going to sort these, what this is showing me is a preview of my OneDrive file directory structure. So just to confirm that, let me go over to here I'm in my OneDrive application. I'm in my Office 365 portal. Right, there's my portal, and I chose the OneDrive application, so it opens up a second tab in my browser. And if you just kind of notice, for example, the first few folders, accounting and financial reports, apps, attachments, Camtasia recordings, And so when I go back to Teams here, you see accounting and financial apps, attachments. So this is just another way to get into my OneDrive to pick a file that I want to include in this message. So I have a demo folder. Let me go ahead and click on that. I just have the one file in it, this course example renamed. It's an Excel spreadsheet. So I want to include this in the message. I just click on it and you see it says share because I'm not uploading. It's already uploaded to OneDrive. So now it's showing me I have an Excel spreadsheet, course example renamed, and it shows where it's located. Personal jhiggins@cpacrossings.com. That's just referring to the fact that it's in my OneDrive. Okay, and I'll just send that off. And there we go. So now Marcia would have access to this file as well. And you can see we have the ellipse here. Now, in this case, and again, here's an example where you start to really see the value of the integration. It's an Excel file. I can do some limited editing to the Excel file in Teams. I can open it up in the desktop version of Excel, and I can open it up in the browser version of Excel, or in this case, Marcia could download the file locally. So you have three choices there, you have four choices, and a fifth choice is to get a link. If I say get a link, what it does is it's creating a link to the file, either in Teams or if I can click OneDrive, and the distinction is not that critical. But so what I've done here, I chose OneDrive. I can copy this link into my clipboard, and then I can paste this link somewhere else and reuse it again. So just know you have those different choices of things you can do with it. So let's just go ahead and open in browser. So what it's doing, it's opening the file from within my OneDrive. And what that means is right now we're actively working on the OneDrive copy of the file. So actually Marcia and I could both be working on the file simultaneously. And if I make any changes, let's say I just want to format these numbers. Let's make them a currency. Oops, let's try it again. There we go. Make them currency with two decimals. There we go. And so now when you're working in the online version of the Office apps, you don't have to save it. You can see it saves it real time as you're working on it. And that's really not what we're trying to get to anyways. But I just want to show you then how in the chat application, you can link directly. You can upload a file from your local device, which uploads it to OneDrive, or you can attach a file, a link to a file that you already have in OneDrive. And let me show you one other thing back in OneDrive. So recall, I uploaded that McKinsey report. Well, where did that get uploaded to? It was uploaded into my OneDrive. You have a specific folder in your OneDrive, Microsoft Teams chat file. I didn't make that. That just gets created automatically. So when I click on that, these are all different files that I have uploaded from my local storage into a Teams conversation, and therefore it's now putting that file in my OneDrive. So here, as you see, the McKinsey report on AI and executives, and the little symbol here shows me this, these three green lines show me that it's been a recently added file. Okay, so hopefully that all makes sense in terms of how that works. Now let's go over to the Teams application, and we're going to type a new message here, and I'll just call this file sharing demo. And once again, we have the paperclip. So now we have more choices because we're in the Teams application. Upload from my computer works the same as what it did as I just showed you in the chat application. Linking to a file in OneDrive, again, that works the same as it did in the chat application I just showed. So what's new? Browse Teams and channels. Okay, so right now, recall, I'm in the Teams demo team in the marketing channel. So when I click Browse Teams and Channels, well, I actually have a file in here, so I could go ahead and click to share that file. But I also have this up arrow here for marketing. If I click this, what that will do is that'll show me the folders, the file folders for all of the other channels in this team. So I have a general channel, I have a customer service channel, and so on. So if I click on customer service, okay, I have this, and these are just all demo files, FYI. So I have this annual report doc. If I select it, I have two choices. This is important to understand. I can upload a copy or I can share a link. So realize this annual report file is stored in the folder labeled customer, well, it's actually the folder within the Teams demo SharePoint site, because every time you create a team, it creates a SharePoint site with the same name. And in that SharePoint site, you have what is called a document library. So the document library in this case is going to be named Teams Demo. And then within the documents library, you have a file folder for each channel. So I have a file folder for general, customer service, events demo, etc. In this case, I'm in the customer service folder. So the point of all that is if I share a link to this file, then in this post, whenever anybody in this post clicks the link, they're actually going to access the original annual report doc file that's stored in the customer service channel. And the reason I can do that is because everybody who's in a team has access to all the files within the various channels within that team, unless I make it a private channel, which that's something we get in a later course. But so everybody in this Teams demo will have access to the files across all the channels. That's why I can share a link. So let's go ahead and do that. And so it's just like we saw with the files that we uploaded to OneDrive. Now it's just showing we have the link to the report that is actually, the file is located in the Teams demo document library, specifically in the customer service folder. And I can click on it and, I've got to hit the arrow here first, because that's when it activates the link, so to speak. Now I can click on it and open it up. And just like we saw in the Excel file a moment ago, now I can preview the Word document in here, and I have some choices. This is the Word application through the view of the Teams app. If I click on the ellipse here, I can open it up in the desktop version of Word, or I can open it up in the browser version of Word, or I can download a copy to my local storage. And over here, we'll have the ability to update the conversation on the right side of the screen while we're viewing the document on the left side of the screen. Okay, let me go ahead and close that. So that's an example of a file sharing demo with a link to a file that's stored somewhere else in the Teams application. Let's go ahead and do another one. So this time I'm going to start another message here to upload another file. And I'll just click on the paperclip. And this time we're going to go back into Browse Teams and Channels. And we're going to move up and we're going to go to Customer Service again. We're going to go to the Annual Report file again. And so you can see here we have two choices. Share a link. That's what I did in the previous example, which means the file remains in this Customer Service folder. If I choose to upload a copy, what that's actually doing is that's making a second copy of the file. You see it progressing there. So the annual report now, I'm going to have it in two places. I'm going to have it in the customer service folder, and I'm also now going to have it in my marketing folder. I don't encourage that. I mean, that's because it's always a potential for problems when you replicate a file. So I'm just showing you how you can do it. I would prefer that you share a link as opposed to copying the file. But just wanted to show you that you have both options. So now I go ahead and send this off. And when we click on this version of the annual report and open it up, once again, everything looks the same at this point. Just realize that, let's go ahead and actually, I'm going to open this up in the desktop version of Microsoft Word. Give it a moment to open here. Okay, so we're in the full desktop version of Microsoft Word, and if I go to the file command, and what you can see here, this is what I wanted to show you, that this version of the file is in the Teams demo SharePoint site in the marketing folder. Whereas the previous example, when I shared a link, it kept that, and they're both here, actually, so you can see them right here. The first one where I shared a link, that version of the file is still stored in customer service. That's the original file. In this case now, I'm actually working with a copy of the file. So I just wanted to focus on that. I know it's a little bit into the weeds there, but I think it's very important for you to understand that as you start to work with files here in the Teams application. Okay, so let's do one more example. I'll start a new conversation here. I'm just going to go ahead and hit the paperclip right out of the gate. And so now we're going to go and browse Teams and Channels one more time. And this time, when I go up one level, remember, these are the folders that are all within the Teams demo team. So everyone here in this team has access to all the files throughout, as I mentioned. But if I go up one more level, now I have access to all of my other teams. So now if I go to, say, my financial team, which not everybody has access to, it's showing me the folders there. Let's go ahead and just pick the general folder. And I'm going to go into this prepaid orders, and I'm going to click this instructions. Notice here, I only have the ability to upload a copy. I don't have the ability to share a link because unless you're a member of the financial team, you're not going to have access to those files. Because I have access to the financial team, I have the ability to copy that file here into, and I'll go ahead and do that here. I can copy that here into the in the marketing demo folder, and then I'll go ahead and send that off. Okay, so now when I click this, it's just like when we did the copy of the annual report. We basically now made a second copy again of this instructions for prepaid webinar pass orders. Okay, so we've covered a lot there in terms of attaching files to chat posts and chat messages and Teams posts. So the main thing to understand is what happens when you upload a file from your local computer or your local storage to include in a message. It actually uploads that into your OneDrive. Alternatively, when you're in the Teams application, you can share a link to a file that's already in OneDrive. You can also share a link or copy a file that is stored somewhere else in the Teams application, either another channel within that same team or another channel in a different team altogether. In that case, when you pull a file from another team, you actually have to make a copy of that file into the current message post. Okay, so lots there. Hopefully that'll help you down the road because this is a very powerful feature of Teams working in conjunction with both SharePoint and OneDrive for your file storage.